Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Kairos, and welcome back once again to Let's Play Silent Hunter 3. We're just about to embark on our second War Patrol, which is very exciting. But before that, I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who has subscribed to my channel thus far. It really does mean a lot to me that you guys are actually watching and enjoying my videos, so thank you all so very much. I've definitely been enjoying making this series, and it's going to keep coming at a fairly regular pace, at least one video a week, I think. So thank you very much, and let's get into this. We have our regular loadout of Type 1s and Type 2s, so that's going to be preferable, I think. It's good to have the variety. We also have a brand new hydrophone, which is going to make our life a lot easier. That cost us a little bit of renown, but definitely worth it, I think. The crew has been kitted out with fancy pieces of metal, which has made them happy. And we have a new sonar man, which is going to make things a lot easier, because I'm not going to have to worry about spending half the time with a tired sonar man. These two can swap each other out, so they won't get exhausted. Really good. So with all that out of the way, I think we can get to this map and see where we're going. We have been sent to DT-53. I really do need glasses, people. Anyhow, I have absolutely no idea where that is, so I guess we'll have to wait to see what's on the other side of this nice loading screen, which I'm going to cut for you so you don't have to suffer through it. I, on the other hand, do have to suffer through it, so I will see you on the other side. Okay, well, we're just farewelling our guardship. He's heading back to port. Thank you very much for your assistance in not crashing into our own mines, old boy. Now, we need to think about where we're headed. So, if I go to the map here, what have we got? Yeah, DT... there it is. I marked it earlier. So, we're going over here, DT-53, which is quite a way. So, what's the plan? The game plan will be to... I think we'll go... just beeline across to Portugal, and then we'll cut fairly close to the Portuguese coast, because I would like to possibly take a quick cheeky peek in here so we can possibly catch something coming out of Gibraltar. You never know. I actually once sunk an aircraft carrier coming out of here, so it's a good place to hunt. And then it's going to be a beeline straight for the... what would you call this? The coast of Africa. So, west coast of wherever this is. My geography's not great. So let's head down that way, and I'll get back to you when we have some action. Well, would you look at that? We've hit some really rough seas. Why am I not surprised? Oh well, I guess rough seas put hair on your chest, right? So anyhow, we have a little bit of news to report, if we go here. As of today, Germany is slightly better off, for we have just sunk the Hood as of today. Bismarck sent a shell through the Hood. For those of you who don't know, she struck her one of her turrets, I think, and the explosion went down into the magazine and blew up the whole ship. So that killed everyone on board except for, I believe, three men survived. The luckiest bastards on the planet. But definitely not a good day for the Royal Navy. Anyhow, we are now... off the coast of Portugal, or northern Spain, up here. And we are still just going to head down, same course. I have definitely decided to cut in here. I'm comforted somewhat by the fact that we have a port we can duck into here, friendly port, if we get into trouble. So we're going to duck into here and just do a little bit of slightly unofficial patrolling for the Royal Navy. We're supposed to be going down to our designated patrol zone, our designated grid, but I think we're going to have more luck in here, so we're going to just tuck in here maybe for a day at most, but that's the plan anyway. I'll get back to you if anything happens. Okay, we have a rather interesting message here. Yes, thank you very much. We have a rather interesting message here. It looks like the Bismarck's in trouble. Yeah, she did well sinking the Hood, but... spoiler alert, but it looks like she might be She might be in for some trouble herself at some point, so we'll see what happens. Anyhow, we've plotted this course here, and I'm going to patrol around this grid, CG86. Just give it one sweep before we head down to our proper patrol grid, which is way down there on the coast of Africa. So, this is a very promising area. I find there's a lot of British shipping coming out of this along this line from Gibraltar. They seem to like travelling in that general direction. So we might end up catching something pretty soon. We haven't seen anything at all, either friend or foe, ever since we left port, so that should hopefully change quite soon. Alright, well, this is very exciting news, people. We have a convoy report not far away at all. Somewhat frustrating, though, because I just finished plotting that nice, neat course. This is going quite slowly, 4 knots. Enemy convoy travel. Oh, it's going northwest, dammit. If it was going northeast, it would be heading straight for us, but it's heading northwest. Ah. So that's out this way, more or less. Damn it! How far out is she? Well, if she's only going... You know what? We're going to cancel this, this patrol here. Of this grid. And I'm going to change course. We're going to go, I think... At least a head full. We're not going to go ahead flank. That's too much fuel. But we'll go ahead full, and we'll see if we can find them. I'll plot out their course. I'll go and look on my compass and see whether I can sort of narrow down the arc of, you know, what direction she might be heading or this convoy might be heading. And we might end up getting, as we get closer, a report. If there are other U-boats in the area, they might be sending reports. So we might end up catching them. I think that's better than just shunting up and down here waiting for the Royal Air Force to come and drop bombs on our head. So I'm going to change course, and we're going to see if we can catch this convoy. We are still chasing this convoy. I've gone to a head full, so we're making pretty good time. We do have some rather bad news from our point of view, and that is that the Bismarck, if we go to this radio message we just received, the Bismarck has been sunk at the hands of the British. It is a sad day for the German people. Yeah, so the Bismarck was hunted down. The British didn't really have much choice but to chase her down. She could have taken out an entire convoy on her own if she'd had a chance. Fortunately for civilization, however, the Germans didn't have that many battleships to waste. So whereas the British could afford to lose a battleship here and there, as we saw just a moment ago with the Hood, the Germans really could not afford to lose those big battleships. That being said, the submarines were always more effective anyway, I think. I mean, depends on who you ask, but I really think that by this point in history, the big battleships have kind of had their day to a certain degree. But anyway, that's another story. Let's continue on and see if we can catch this convoy that's making its way very slowly to the northwest. Here's hoping. It'd be wonderful if we could catch it. We could finally get a proper convoy attack in this series. Okay, we have an aircraft spotted here. We are crash diving. I don't like the look of this at all. Down we go, boys. Down we go. This is why we had that drill earlier. I was not expecting that. I wonder if there's an aircraft carrier in the area. It might be a seaplane. Alright, well, we're down. Gee, that dives fast. Yeah, I wasn't going to stay on the surface for that. And also, they'll probably report in my position. Yeah, it's definitely worth staying away from aircraft. So I wonder what she'll do. We spotted her quite far off. So that's well done on the part of the men there. They got eyes like hawks. You can level off now. That's fine. Guys, it's deep enough. Well, just shows we've got to keep on our toes. Okay, I've been doing some calculations here. What have we got? Okay, so they were going 4 knots, which means they should be doing about 7 kilometers, 7.5 kilometers every hour. So let's round that off as 8, because, you know, they're probably going a little bit faster than that. They might have been turning, which would be bad. That might explain why they dropped to such a slow speed. But we'll try this anyway. 7 Let me think about this. 7 times, how many hours has it been? About 10 hours, I calculated earlier. I think we saw it at, yeah, it's about 10 hours. So 7 times 10 equals 70. So they could have gone, just get this out of the way, wonderful tool. It's been very helpful. So they could have gone about 70. Oh man, we've got a little way to go. They shouldn't be far away, surely. Am I doing that right? Bit further than that, actually. Let's make it 80. Just in case they've added a knot on. It has been about 10 hours, hasn't it? It's now... Okay, well, I'll keep looking. I've got a feeling they might be quite close by. So, yeah, this could be very successful. Assuming they haven't changed course, which is the other possibility. Anyway, I could be just doing the calculations wrong. There's all kinds of factors to consider here. Alright, well, bad news, people. I'm afraid we didn't catch that convoy. Didn't get any indication she was anywhere in the area. So, either I got those calculations completely wrong, in which case you're free to yell at me in the comments, or they were in the middle of a turn and they were just heading in a slightly different direction. Yeah, there's just nothing around here, so I'm going to give up the chase and we're just going to go back along this track in case they're still here somewhere. Very disappointing, but I'm sure there'll be more convoys around. I'm going to slow down now, because we've wasted far too much fuel in that pursuit. Quite frustrating, actually. Okay, good news, people. I decided to assume that they wouldn't change course and come and sort of try and intercept them. I went back up to ahead flank just for a few hours and covered the distance. Couldn't find anything and thought, yeah, okay, right, they've gone. And just as I go back down to head slow, just as I turn down to head south towards our patrol zone, we get another update. So look at that. They are heading northwest. North-northwest. It's important. I've got to read that very carefully, because otherwise we'll make another terrible mistake. Now, what is north-northwest? I'm going to have to do the... I can't remember the degrees, what north-northwest is. It's about that. I'll look it up. So we need to turn around and go looking for this. Hopefully the next time you see me, people, at the next cut, we will actually have a... we will have some action. Now, I do need to find out exactly how quick she's going, however. So let's take a note of these details before they disappear. Radio report, large convoy, grid G. Yeah, we know that. 6 knots, that's what we want. 6 knots. So let's see how quick they'll go. I'll fix this later to make sure I'm exactly on, but assuming northwest is about that, right? I'll double check that just to make sure, but it's about that. So they'll cover, let me see, 6 knots. We need, I don't know what 6 knots is off the top of my head. Let's do the conversion. Stunde. It's about, yeah, okay, we're going to round that up to 12. That's usually what I like to do. So round it up to 12. 12 kilometers per hour. So they're going, in 2 hours, they should do 24. They should do about that. So I'll add that for a start. And then if we can't catch them there, we can try again for another couple of hours. They'll be up here. Let's add a little bit there just to be safe. Okay, so I'm definitely going to go ahead flank for this. Hang on, let's have a look at our fuel situation. Pretty good. What distance are we talking here? They're only 40 kilometers out. Let's do this. We're going to catch this. This is going to be good. We're going to have a convoy attack. I'm excited for this. Let's go ahead flank and intercept.
Wahnsinnige Fahrt voraus.
Okay, we have the convoy. There it is. And it's about 20 kilometers out. So it looks like they were making more of a that way direction. I did check that course I had them on. That is more or less northwest. It should be, I think, 350 degrees on this thing. So, oh, okay. Yeah, that's about right, actually. There's an arc, as I say. So I think they're heading in that direction. So now we've just got to catch them. Now, it is pretty We're getting pretty close to that destroyer there. We've got one destroyer there and one destroyer there, which I'm going to keep marked. I think we're probably close enough. Yeah, we're easily far away enough, I should say. I can't English today. That we can avoid. Yeah, we can avoid them. So we're going to go back on the surface and take advantage of this weather to loop around and actually catch them. We're assuming they're still going 6 knots, so we should be able to get in front of them within an hour or so, I think. That should be about right. All right. Yeah, I think we can get about 20 kilometers in front of them, and we should be absolutely fine. Yeah. Make it 25, 24 just to be safe, and then we'll duck back in here, and we'll have them. All right, they are getting quite close. I'm going to slow down a little bit here. They're about 5 kilometers out now, and we can see quite distinctly where the columns are. Or at least some of them. It's not an exact science, this, but we've got an idea of where they're heading. Now, I'm a little bit worried about this, though. We've got a destroyer, and I'm not entirely sure whether it's close or not, but there's a destroyer or two here running straight in the middle of the column. I think what's going on is that there's one in the front and then there's one behind, more or less on the same bearing, which is making me a little nervous. So we might end up having to take evasive action here, but the only way to find out is to raise this scope. I don't think we'll be able to see anything at this point, but we'll keep it up because I want to have all the warning we can get. With zero visibility, look at that rain. With zero visibility, we're not going to be able to see a thing, but I'll keep the scope up. Risky strategy, but I'd rather be able to see them coming at me in the mist than have them roll over the top of my head without realizing. So let's keep that scope up and continue our slow but steady progress towards our target. I might get a bit more speed here. I'm sure the periscope will be fine just chugging along at that kind of speed, so we'll get a few knots up and get closer. Okay, it looks like we have our first contact, ship visual contact, that is. What is that? Oh god, that looks like a destroyer, doesn't it? I can't tell. God damn it, I can't tell. Is it a warship? I think it's a warship. Contact warship moving fast, bearing... Yeah, it's a warship. Damn it, let's get down. Right now. Got a... Damnation. I knew I shouldn't have gone straight down the middle of the column here. Let's put some, slowly, I'm gonna try and... Damn it, change course, please. Which way do we want to go, left or right? Let's go to the right. Starboard. Oh, I don't know. It's unknown, I can't tell what it is. But I do know that we want to stay low, and we want to stay quiet. So once we get... there'll be plenty of convoy to pop up and have a look at, but for now we need to get some depth under the keel. And I'll leave this running now for a bit, so we can see what we're dealing with. As I say, there'll be plenty of convoy to pick on, and I think that, you know, considering that some of these look like they're quite far out, I think this is going to be a destroyer, an advance guard destroyer. That's it. Yeah, it is. It's a warship. I think that's it there. So that's the problem with all of these lines. Yeah, we're being pinged, people. That's not good. We're being pinged. Damn it. Okay, crash dive. Bring us down. Action stations, lads. Damn it. What a way to screw up an attack. I think we're about to get depth charged. This could be the end of us. These men are tired. Some of these men are tired. All right, change course. This way. Oh, I can't see a thing with all these lines. What am I doing?
Derzeitige Tiefe 6-0.
Gotta clean this up. Ah, that's better. I can see what I'm doing now. Yeah, we're gonna get explosions, people. This is where I wanna go. I like to use this so I can see where I'm going exactly. We're gonna turn back into them. Which they won't be expecting, hopefully. See, I made a mistake there as well by place. Oh, I didn't mean to do that quite that to that degree. I was gonna go more of a that kind of angle. But unfortunately, I gave them a full profile there. That was very clumsy on my part. But, oh well. My captain's kind of green. Klaus doesn't know what the hell he's doing, apparently. So what depth are we reading now? Deeper, please.
Neue Tiefe, 9,4 Meter.
And now rig for silent running, which is here. Yeah, they're over the top of us. Silent running.
Schleichfahrt. Schleichfahrt. Derzeitige Tiefe 7-0.
Okay, we're gonna get depth charged.
Wasserbomben.
Yeah, we're okay. Hold on, people. This is it. Ahead, flank.
Wahnsinnige Fahrt voraus. Wahnsinnige Fahrt. Derzeitige
Bring us down.
Tiefe 8-0. Neue Tiefe 1-5 Meter.
Ooh. I don't know how close they were, and we're not going to go outside to find out because we're playing this realistically. Whoa, okay, we got rattled. Okay, now. Still on silent running. Yep. Keep diving, bring us down. Okay, now slow. I mean slow. 1 knot.
Derzeitige Fahrt 1 Knoten.
Right, well there we go. We did in fact get depth charged. That is the first time we've been in danger really for this career. Okay, well wonderful news. We're being pinged again. I think we're about to get depth charged. Yes, I was right about that. Ahead full.
Wahnsinnige Fahrt voraus.
And I want you to bring us down. Deeper, please. Deeper. There's nothing else I can do. I could try and turn, I suppose, but... It's strange. I didn't hear their engines, but I did hear them pinging me. Whoa, we're dropping fast. Okay. Thank you, Chief. Keep those reports coming. Good.
Derzeitige Tiefe 150.
Down to 1.
Derzeitige Fahrt.
Ooh, that was close. That was very, very close. That was right over our heads, I think. So I made the right choice diving deeper. It's gonna take a lot of effort to shake this lot. You've got a bit of your hair missing, old boy. Oh well. That's a glitch, I think. Well, I just thought it would be cool to sort of get a look at our enemy here. We are making slow progress away from the area. I think we might be okay, but this destroyer is doing a sweep over us. It is, however, apparently not that interested in throwing anything at us, which is really nice. This is where I wanted to be, right in the middle of the convoy. But because I'm just below this. There are a couple of destroyers looking for me where I was earlier, just a little bit north of this area. But unfortunately, this one is still hovering around, so I couldn't possibly surface to attack or, go to periscope depth to attack. I would never surface even in these conditions. It's just too dangerous. These ships have guns, man. I'm not going to get crew killed this way. But it's cool to actually have a look at them. Of course, we have no idea what's up here. We can just hear them in our submarine. But I thought you guys might like to have a look at the enemy, seeing as we're not getting a shot at them at the moment. That's the best I can offer you, I'm afraid. That's a lot of depth charges. We're going to get some nice explosions in a moment. So I'll show you this just for fun.
Wasserbomben.
I'm happy to say we are nowhere near here, so that makes me happy. Come on. There's going to be a bang. I know there's going to be a bang. It's starts back away a little bit. So there's the destroyer. These depth charges do, of course, have a delay. There we go. Wow, it does look really good, doesn't it? I mean, for a game this old. Ooh, it's making me shudder just thinking about it. Wow. He's really going to town on us. Well, at least he thinks he is. You're dropping bombs on the wrong spot, Dick Biscuit. Okay, that's enough taunting the enemy. Let's get on with our escape plan, shall we? Alright, so just a quick update here for you guys, so you can see what's going on. The convoy is moving off, and it looks like the destroyers have given up the chase. We were over there, where that cross is, now we are down here, so we've been covering some distance. It's very frustrating, but they did get away from us. But fear not, we are going to loop around and have another go at them. We didn't get any damage, as far as I can tell. No, we did not. So we can probably take these men out of damage control soon and think about surfacing at some point. But I definitely want to stay down here until I'm absolutely sure that there are no destroyers in the area. So I will deal with that and then get back to you once we've got ahead of them and moved into position for a second attack. Right, well, here we are. We're in position and the weather is god-awful. As a matter of fact, it's so damn dark out there, I wonder whether we'll even be able to see them ourselves. It might be too dark even to get a solution on them, but we're going to have a go anyway. Let's go to periscope depth and see if we can find these little buggers.
Auf zero tief again.
So here we are, as you can see. Definitely need to slow down. So last I heard them, they were about here. It's been an hour or so since then, so they'll be most likely right here, I think. Around that area. Assuming they're going about 12 kilometers per hour, which seems to be what we're talking here. So yeah, this is where we're gonna be. And we're gonna try and intercept them. This time I'm gonna be off slightly. I'm not gonna go straight down the middle. I'm gonna go more in that kind of direction. So let's see if we can hear them from start. See if I'm right. Yep. Oh, I was close. Actually, I wasn't close at all. Or was I? Yeah, no, I was about right. There we go. Yeah. So there we go. So the plan will be to just continue like this. Maybe a little bit more like that. Try and avoid that destroyer. Hope I haven't gone to periscope depth too early. Anyway, we'll do our best try and intercept. Hopefully we'll get a shot at them. Let's see what we can find. Okay, well, this weather is just terrible. I can see the destroyers out there. Their lights are giving them away, but you know, they're looking for me, all right, but I can't see anything out here. I don't see how we can possibly catch them in this weather. You know, if I can't see them, I can't shoot at them. That looks like something there, I don't know, but there's another destroyer there looking for us. They're not far off at all. I can see the silhouette there. Medium, see, it's... It's not far away at all, and the last thing I want is to get heard again. So let's go to silent running. Propulsion, rig for silent running. No, rig for silent running, please.
Schleifer.
I don't know, people, this is just... Nothing's working. Whoa! Oh, hello! Okay, that's helpful. right, well, we know what direction they're going now. So, I guess... Thank you. I'll say that the crew has better eyes than I do. That's this. So there's one there, one there. Whoops, one column. Am I imagining things, or are there destroyers heading straight for me? Those look like they're closing in on me, don't they? Would you say that means I'm breakfast again? I really don't want this all over again. God. Blast and damnation. You know what we're going to do? we are going to fire a torpedo straight down the neck of whatever this is. So we want a torpedo on a bearing of, let's go. Okay, so we got men very tired, guys, already in battle stations here. I'm just going to fire at it. I want to shoot a torpedo down here and just stir things up. I'm getting frustrated. And we know that there's something there. So let's open this. No, wait a minute. I need to think about this, people. What do we think its bearing will be? Let's have a look at this. Let's take some lightning fast solutions here. Let's assume that we're shooting this thing. What bearing is that on? No, they're up here. Oh man, oh man, oh man. Okay, what we might do instead is change course. Okay, that's a destroyer heading straight for us. We've been spotted. Okay, we're gonna fire straight down here. I don't have time to set this up. Unlock. Yep, okay, lock that. Range. Okay, that's, they're literally heading straight for us there. So let's have speed, let's just say 6. Just add that properly. Speed, what am I saying? Range. Sorry, people, I'm fumbling here. We'll just put that at 1,000. Let's have a look at this map here. Okay, that's going to have to do. Open tube 1. We're just going to fire one torpedo, and then we're going to dive. Tube 1. Fire. And then let's get the hell out of here. Crash dive. That's actually looking pretty damn good. I wish I'd fired 2 now. Drop the scope. Both scopes in case I don't know which one I had. I know, they're pinging us. I know. Okay, we're going to get some action. Battle safe. Get some crew on damage control. Get everyone. Get out of the torpedoes. We don't need to reload those. That does not sound good. Keep dropping. Let's have a listen. You can hear that torpedo. Damn it. Keep going down. Oh, this is insane. I didn't realize they were that close. I had no idea they were that close. What are we doing for depth? Keep going down. Keep going.
Neue Tiefe 102 Meter.
I don't think we're going to get anything with that torpedo. Still going. Well, it was worth a shot. It was damn close, in fact. Damn close. I'll keep it going until we're sure. Anyway, we're about to get depth charged. Get us down. While you're at it, change course.
Derzeitige Tiefe 8-0.
Starboard.
Oder
go to port, what am I saying? Go to port. Alright, that torpedo definitely missed.
Tiefe 9-0.
Now we have to deal with this slot again. That was a very sloppy attack. I'm sorry, people. I feel slightly under pressure to perform after having buggered up last time, so. But hey. Now we have the excitement of yet again being depth charged.
Derzeitige Tiefe 1-0.
Well, to say that we stirred up the hive somewhat would be the understatement of the millennium. This is quite a mess up here. We've completely driven the convoy batshit insane. They are just going round and round in circles, and we can hear them. Of course, we couldn't see them like this, but if we were to poke our heads above water, this is what we would see. Absolute chaos. That sounds like depth charges. Or possibly, no, I'd say that was a star. Yeah, star flare, whatever they call them. Somewhere around here, it's lit up the place. But anyway, that's the convoy, and that's what we could not see. before. There's a destroyer over there. So yeah, so they've just lit up the place with that shell. So now we can actually see. They know we were just here, but they're not going to catch us now. We're too deep. They can't hear us in the storm. So it looks like I'm going to be doing some evading. And yet again, people, we are going to be having to report our, failure, essentially. It's not a good word, but yeah. This weather is not making it easy for me, in my defense. It's just really, really hard to see what I'm doing. I'm sure you can relate. So I guess I'll just keep evading them and see whether we get hit. All right, well, we've definitely given these buggers the slip, so now we can finally think about yet again tracking them with the hydrophone, anticipating where they are going to pop out. They've changed course again. They're over there. So, yeah, basically we're going to follow them along this line and then try yet again. I'm actually starting to think that the weather is just too bad for an attack, so we might wait till daylight, actually, to try and catch them, but... I'm beginning to think that unless this rain stops, we might not actually be able to hit them. The visibility is that bad that we can't even get close enough to... we have to get literally right in their faces to get a shot at them. And by the time we get close enough, the destroyers are on top of us. So it's just really, really challenging. And I really don't like attacking at close range. I prefer to shoot at convoys at a fairly decent range. So this is... quite a challenge for me, but I hope it's keeping you lot entertained. It's certainly keeping me on my toes. All right, it's dawn, so I guess we're ready to take a peek. Let's have a look. Oh, this is how I... Ooh, nice. That's better. That's better. We can see it at least a few feet in front of our face now. Well, the rain isn't letting up, though, so... There don't appear to be any destroyers on the horizon, which is nice, because there's nothing more stressful than surfacing on top of one of those. Alright, surface the boat, and, let's get on with this. So I'm giving them a wide berth, and we know that they're heading in this general direction, so unless they change course, we'll be able to intercept them maybe a few... Maybe I'll... go maybe 50 to 100 miles ahead of them to try and really get a good intercept course. Hopefully by then as well we'll have less rain and better visibility. That would be nice. So let's see if we can do this. This is probably going to be my last attempt at this, otherwise I just don't see how else we can catch them. I could shadow them until the weather clears, but you know, I'm already using up too much fuel. Look how much fuel I've been using here. Oh, too bad. Okay. I thought I was down to 75%, so maybe I will shadow them for a while longer, but we'll see how we go. All right, here they are. We've intercepted them. I'm trying to be a bit smarter about it this time, but we still have destroyers. Where is it? Come on, where is it? I know it's here somewhere. It's 5 degrees. There she is. Let's get down a little bit. I've reached for silent running. We're going to slow right down so they can't hear us. That is a destroyer which is alarmingly coming towards us. Let's get some depth under the keel. We're not going to be able to get down very far at this, very fast, I should say, at this speed. But it's better than getting caught again. Oh, damn it. I don't know if I'm... I really don't know. See, I couldn't see that on the sonar. For some reason, that wasn't coming up on the sonar. I was trying to avoid this one here and this one here. This one at the back. It's so dark and so noisy out there. What we have to do now is just listen out for pings. If they ping us, we'll be in trouble. Secret is to stay quiet and try and get deep. I probably should have started to go lower before. Because there's always a destroyer at the front. Now you tell me it's out there. Thank you. Gee, it's freaking... Okay. What? Okay, that's just... I don't know. Anyway, we're in position, as you can see. So if we can evade this forward destroyer, we might be able to get a shot at them. We've got a column here and a column there, which means if they're heading in this general direction, we should be getting something like this, if I can get this damn thing right. One there. Ah, get out of my way. Okay. One going in that sort of direction, another one coming more or less straight for us. Probably about that. So if we can just continue like this, I don't want to go much further that this way because otherwise we're going to get sprung by this destroyer that's going to come round. So you can see how tight it is. It's quite tactical, this game, at times. This is how I like to play Silent Hunter 3. It's taken me all damn night to do this, and only just now are we getting into a position to finally fire at something. We're going to keep on gradually drifting down. Actually, no. Let's stop it. Let's stop at 30, because I don't want to get too deep. It'll take too long to surface. Because, obviously, I don't want to speed up the engines too much or we're going to get sprung yet again. I wonder if I can still see up there. Maybe just. Or are we too deep now? I'd say we're too deep. Yeah, we're down actually pretty far. That's not too bad. So that's good. Lower that scope. Do it. This. Alright, people, I'm gonna keep going, and I'll get back to you if we have any disasters or if we see something worth shooting at. Well, wonderful news. Absolutely wonderful news. Need I say anything? The enemy is pinging us. We did actually get a thing bouncing off the hull there, so you have no idea how annoying this is. Crash dive. All right. Let's have a look outside this time. We've got to make this episode interesting somehow. Right? So where is this destroyer that is so anxiously... Oh, it's coming straight for us. So we'll get to see this run. I will keep... Just make sure that you keep going down.
Neue Tiefe, 1, 2, 8 meter.
Okay, so we're diving as quickly as we can. 5-0. I'm not entirely sure.
Tiefe, 6-0.
There we are, we're down there. Look, see, he can hear us alright. He's chasing us. They're pretty good at their job, actually. We should probably change course.
7-0.
Keep going. Keep going. Change course.
Tiefe, 8-0.
I always change course when I, actually, no, what am I doing? It's better to go this way, because it's further away from the convoy.
Tiefe, 9-0.
Although in some ways it's better to go into it, because, you know, then they get confused crashing into their own ships. Well, not crashing into their own ships, but they have to sort of navigate around.
Tiefe,
so let's watch
1,
this.
0,
we're
going to
get
0.
Hit. Or we're going to get depth charged anyway. Oh, man, this is not good. They're spot on.
Derzeitige Tiefe, 1-0.
There they go. Boom. Holy shit. They are spot on. We're going to get rattled. Where are we?
Derzeitige Tiefe, 1-2-0.
Oh, I don't like those. I don't like those at all.
Derzeitige Tiefe, 1-3-0.
The game models them really nicely, though. I hope that you can see that. It's pretty dark down here, but I think they're going to miss us. Oh, not by much, though. There's our submarine. Look at that. Look at that. Gee. Boom. Boom. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I've already done everything I can to evade them, so now we're just... Ooh. Well, well, well. Pretty damn good shooting, kid. Alright. Now we do our normal thing of slowing the hell down, staying quiet. We're going to continue with this course, and I'm going to do everything I possibly can to evade them. But, yeah, that's going to be a little tricky now that the whole convoy knows we're here. Well, that was utterly exhausting, both for me and for the crew. We're just coming to periscope depth now. We've evaded the destroyers. We've evaded the convoy, which was, you know, right on top of us for a while there. Very disappointing. They've actually changed course. I'll go show you. I think we freaked them out because they changed course entirely. They were over here, and I was just sort of shadowing them, waiting for the destroyers to get sick of chasing me. And then they just did a, you know, about turn almost. They came back on themselves, and now they're heading in that direction. So with that, I'm thinking it's time to break contact and accept that we aren't going to be able to catch anything here. I'm sorry, I know you're all very disappointed to hear that, but, you know, the weather is just too bad out here. I'm finding it very difficult to get close enough to have a shot at these guys. It's just not working for me this time. So we're going to call this this one to a close. The plan will be to sort of follow in their general direction for a little while longer, once it gets dark, in the hope that maybe next episode we'll have better weather and we'll be able to catch them again. But for now, I'm going to break contact, and we're going to, well, let the crew have a rest. They've done really well. It just didn't happen this time around. It wasn't working for us this time. So thank you for viewing. I hope you're not too disappointed. I will see you all in the next episode.